So now you have seen the notification concepts. Now let's just see a small application to how to design a notification. I will create a small app calling it my notification demo. Again, I will use the minimum as 15, empty activity, and finish. In this particular application, I'm going to design a button, and when you click on that button, a notification will be popping up. Let's see how we can do that. First, I will design a pretty good UI here. Let me just delete this text view, and I'm going to create my own text view here, and I'm going to call it notification. And let me just increase the size to 30 SP. Great. Now I'm going to design a button. Just drag and drop button, and I call it open notification. I'm going to do it match parent. There you go. Now, I'm going to do onClick attribute here so that when you click on the button, something should happen. So I'm calling it do something. I just put Alt plus Enter, and it will be getting created in my main activity. Here, I need to put the code to get to my notification. So how can I do that? Well, first thing I need is my notification manager. So I can get that notification manager. If I can use normal notification manager also, or notification manager compact also. If I want to use the backward compatibility, so I will be using for notification manager compact for backward compatibility here. I will call it my manager equals to get the access of the object of notification manager compact. I will do notification manager compact dot form and pass the context object as this. Next I need is notification object. So again, as I'm using compact manager classes, so here also I will be using notification compact dot builder class. It is an inner class inside it. I will do what my noti equals to new builder, there you go, and this, there you go. That's the context object. Next, I'm going to design a very basic notification here, which will be having a title and a context text and an icon. So how can I set those things? My noti dot set content title. Let me just call it one new message. Generally, you will be not hard coding it. You will be getting it from some intent or from some other sources. My note dot set content text. Here also, I'm just doing hard coding. Hi, how are you? Last is your icon. So I can do set small icon. You can set the large icon also if you have a high resolution one. And I don't have my own icon right now in my drawable, so I will be using Android drawable. So android.r.drawable. So if you want to access your Android drawable classes or Android r.java file, then you will be using android.r. If you are using your own r.java file, then you can just put r. Any class name. So here I'm using android.r java file. So inside Android drawable, there will be button named IC speak button now. So you can see this here. This will be the icon. Mic will be the icon for my notification. Once I have this notification set up, next I need is my intent object. Because once the user click on my notification, where exactly it needs to transfer. So I will put I1 equals to new intent. And here, if I have another activity, I will give from this, that is context object, and give the name of that other activity. If I, let's say I want to make sure, you know, the user comes to this class only or this activity only, there you go. So if you have another activity, you can give the name of other activity. And next is, I will wrap this intent inside my pending intent. So how can I do that? PD equals to pending intent dot get activity. Get activity, and it will have four parameters. First will be your context object. Let's just put this, and second will be your request code, because there may be a chance that different notifications are transferring you to different classes. So for that, how will you distinguish? You will put a different request code on those different pending intent objects. Next, you need the intent itself. What is the intent you are wrapping up? Mine is I1. Last is your flag. Zero will make sure that there is always a one instance of that application you are creating the notification for. And at the end, my noti dot set content intent, because it's an intent now, content intent, and call it PD. Yeah, just pass that PD now. One more thing I need to set in my notification is, every time you click on the notification, after your notification has been interacted, it will open up that activity, that is main activity, but your notification will be still remaining on your notification bar. So you want to make sure that your notification go away once you interact with it. So for that, noti dot set auto cancel true. That's it. And after that, you can put, you have to notify your manager, notification manager. That you can do by my manager dot notify. And here, first argument will be ID, because there can be more than one notification. So to distinguish between each notification, there will be an integer value. You can use different integer value for different notification. And then your notification object dot build it. That's it. That's all you have to do. Now, let's say in this particular example, once you click on that button, once you click on this button known as open notification, you click on this, the notification will be getting fired and it will be up in the notification bar. At the same time, I want to close this application also, or close this activity also. It's up to you. It's just the functionality I'm providing. If you don't want to, just don't provide this finish. Okay. Now, let's just run this. It should show me a basic notification now. So as you can see, my application is up running in the emulator. Now, when you click on this button, what should happen? A notification should appear, and at the same time, your activity should be finished. Let's see. There you go. And you can see at the top, there is an icon now. That is a mic icon, and the notification is on the notification bar. When I drag it down, you can see that notification is there, telling me one new message, the same thing which I provided in content title, and hi, how are you, the thing which I provided in content text. When I click on this notification, I will get transferred to the main activity, as you can see, right? And the notification is gone because I set the auto cancel true. So that was a basic example of notification. There is a lot more you can do with the notification by providing the action buttons, by providing the priorities, and by setting the big style text notification and all. I will let you guys explore those notification options. And do try the notification which are given in the Git book practical. So that's it from my side in notification. Thank you.